Hey guys, welcome back to another video on the channel, and this is part 1 of Let's Build a Small Military Airbase in Minecraft. So in this video, we are going to build this AC-130 hangar that you can see in front of you guys, and the mods that you will need in order to build this are MC Heli and Flanix's Rod mod. I will link both of these mods down in the description. Also, if at any point of time you feel that the video is going too fast, make sure to slow it down to see what is going on in the building. So yeah guys, without any further ado, let's get straight into it. So the blocks you need in order to build the hangar are concrete road, stone brick stairs, stone slab, dark tarmac road, and you will also need white thick single line paint and also letter X paint. Now these 4 blocks right here are from Flanix's road mod, and the remaining 3 blocks are from Vanilla Minecraft. So initially we need to build a rectangle which is 43 blocks in width and 49 blocks in length, and on this rectangle we are going to place our AC-130. So let's build this 43 by 49 rectangle. And in order to do this quickly, I'm gonna use World Edit. And the block that we are gonna use in order to build this rectangle is going to be the concrete road block. Stack it 42 times so that it is total 43 blocks. And this is going to be the front side of our hangar. There. So now we have a 43 by 49 rectangle. Let's double check the size again. And there we go. So now once you have built this rectangle, come to the front side of the hangar and come to the middle point of this rectangle that we have made, which should be around the 22nd block. Now from the 22nd block, start placing your white thick single line paint and place it on every other block. Now with this line, you have divided your entire hangar into 2 equal parts. And let's double check that. So on either side, there should be 21 blocks in total. And that will total up to 43 blocks. On this side as well. There we go, 21 blocks. Now from the front side, come 14 blocks back. And on the 14th block, we need to place letter X paint. And there we go. Now on this letter X, we are going to place our AC-130. And once you place that, as you can see, it will leave ample space on both the front side and the back side of the plane. Now we need to start working on the gate or the main hangar door section. So build a 9 high pillar, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And this pillar should be made with stone bricks. Now come 14 front. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. Now build this 5 high. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now let's repeat the same thing on the other side. So 9 high in total. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, and 14 long. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 5 high. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And now connect these 2 blocks. There we go. Now from this pattern we made, leave a 1 block gap and repeat this similar pattern, and make sure to leave this 1 block gap, as that is where our door is gonna go. Place it like this, and there we go. Now that we have done this on the front side, repeat the same process on the back side. And we are done. So now after completing both the sides like this, extend 4 more blocks so that this is 5 long in total. And connect the pattern that we made with the top pattern here. Make sure to fill it all up, but leave the gap that we have created. Now repeat this thing on all the four sides, on all the four corners that is. So make sure that you have added four blocks behind it, so that it is five long in total, and then fill it up like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and fill it up. And the final side. Okay, so with this, the main door section of the hanger is now completed. So let's connect the corners of this door in order to make the wall of the hanger. And use stone bricks for this wall as well. Now you can mix the blocks up if you want to. A different pattern for the lower blocks and a different pattern for the upper blocks. But I'm just gonna go with stone bricks for this one. And there we go. Now after completing the walls of the hanger, it's now time to start working on some of the pillars. So come diagonally out from the corners that we created and build a 9 high pillar. Now leave a 7 block gap. So on the 8th block, place down another pillar. There we go. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and on the 8th block, place down a pillar. And repeat this process until you reach the very end of the hanger. If you did this correctly, then you should reach the corner section of the diagonal like this. And now extend all these blocks down till the ground. There we go. And repeat the very same thing on the other side of the wall. Make sure to leave a 7 block gap in between and place the blocks on the 8th one. There we go. Okay. So now that this is done, it's now time to start working on the roof of the hanger, which is going to be the main part. So come up 3 blocks like this from the corner block that we placed, then come up by 1 and place 3 more blocks. Again, come up by 1 and place 3 more blocks and repeat this pattern. 1, 2 and 3, come up by 1. And make sure that you don't place any more than 3, as this is going to give the roof a really good slope. Come up by 1 and then 1, 2 and 3. Now once you reach this block right here, come up by 1. And then extend this all the way up to the middle of the roof, or sorry, the middle of the hanger. And then let's repeat the same thing on the other side. So 1, 2 and 3. Oops. There we go. And come up by 1. And then 1, 2 and 3. And up by 1. Now you can try out different roof patterns, but I found that this one gives a really good slope for the height of the SE130 hanger. So yeah, I'm gonna go with this one for this video. And finally, 2 and 3. Now once you hit this block here, come up by 1 and then extend it all the way back until you connect it to the roof that we placed before. So this long section here is going to be the flat section of the roof, and the three parts that we placed are going to be the slope. So now start placing stone brick slabs like this on every block that we have placed. And there. Now once you have done that, it's time to break the temporary wool blocks that we placed, and then you have to extend this entire pattern up until the very end of the hanger. till it reaches an overhang of 1, like it has reached here. So now our hanger is a total of 59 blocks in length. So I'm going to use world edit in order to stack all of these blocks 58 more times. 1 and 2, and then stack 58. So now if we take a look back, hold on. Okay. So now if we take a look here, as you can see, the roof is overhanging by one block, and that is exactly how it is in the front side as well. And that is exactly what you want to be happening in this hanger. On the sides, the roof should be overhanging by two blocks, and in the front side, it should be overhanging by one block. So let's do the same for every other section of the roof. Now the reason I didn't do this all at the same time is because if you do that, it is gonna eat up some of the door blocks that you have created due to air being in there. So yeah. So with that, our roof is entirely completed. Now it's time to start filling up the roof and connect it with the door that we have created. So start placing stone bricks and connect them up to the roof like this, but make sure to leave this gap that we have created. That is pretty important. It is going to give the door a really clean look, but if you do want to fill it, you can. It's your hanger after all. Let's fill it up all the way until it starts touching the roof. And once this is completed, it is going to give this hanger a really clean look. And there we go. So once this is completed, look how good the hanger looks from the front side. Now let's do the same thing for the back end of the hanger. And finally, here we go. So with this completed, we have successfully connected the roof of the hanger with the door of the hanger. Now it's time to do some detailing work. Take your stone brick stairs and start placing them on the periphery of the hanger. So place them wherever between there is space between two pillars like this. And do that on all the four sides. Now once you have placed stairs on the bottom side, start also placing them upside down on the top side. Now once you reach the sides like this, place them between the pillars. I'm not very good at detailing. So yeah, you guys can get as creative as you want in this part. And we have successfully completed that. So now it's time to fill up this sand that we have inside the hanger and in the front part of the hanger. And we are going to do that with the dark tarmac door. So until the door ends at the very end block, fill it up with dark tarmac blocks like this. And there we go. Now let's also do that on all the other parts of the hanger. And this contrast with the dark tarmac road and the concrete road is gonna look really good, as it is going to give that a box feeling, that yeah, as you can see here. Now let's take some iron blocks, and with these iron blocks we are going to make a door. So take these iron blocks and come to any part of the hangar where there is a door, the front part or the back part, and start placing these iron blocks in a straight line by 9 blocks. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So these iron blocks represent the door of the hangar, and do that on all the remaining three sides as well. And there we go. So with this, the door of the hangar is now completed. Finally, the last part of this tutorial is going to be placing some lights. So come to the long section, the very end of the long section, and 2 blocks away from the roof, place down some lights. Then leave a 7-block gap, and on the 8th block, place down one more light. And you should come, that light should be at the very center of the hangar. And then again, after a 7-block gap, place down one more light. Now leave a 7-block gap, and then on the 8th block, place down one more glowstone. And repeat this until you reach the other side of the hangar. So 7-block gap, and on the 8th block, a glowstone or any light source that you want. Now repeat this process with the other 2 points that we have created. And after doing that, we are going to place 2 more light sources. So come forward by 7 blocks, 7, and then on the 8th block, place down light source. Then once again, come out by 7 blocks, and on the 8th block, 2 blocks below from the roof, place down another light source and extend them until they reach the very end. Now this step is optional, but placing down walls like this and connecting them to the roof is going to make your hangar look really good. Now as I said, I'm not very good at interior designing, so you guys can get as creative as you want to in this step. But the basic structure for the AC-130 hangar according to its size is going to be like this. With this shape and size of the hangar, your wings are not going to touch the door, and you can easily and comfortably fit your entire plane in there with any machinery or basically any repair station that you want to build inside the hangar. You can even place secondary doors on the sides of the hangar for easy access, and we are going to do that in the later episodes of this series. But yeah, for now, by placing down these lights, the tutorial will be completed. Now, after connecting all of these lights with the roof, for these 3 lights that we placed in the middle, you can even connect them like this to give it more of a sturdy feel. Connect them like this. And yeah. Finally, there we go. And with this, our entire hangar is completed. So yeah guys, that was all I had for this video. I hope you guys liked this build. If you did, do smash that like button and also subscribe to the channel for more content like this. Peace out guys, stay safe.